I've been following a LEGO channel named Brick Vault for some time now, and recently they put a LEGO mock onto their web store that caught my attention. The UCS Resurgence Class Star Destroyer from The Force Awakens. Now, UCS is usually reserved for Ultimate Collector's Series, which is an official LEGO series, but in some circles, it's come to mean models that are really large and detailed. This model has at least more pieces than the UCS Millennium Falcon, and I decided that I would film the process of making this model and review how well Brick Vault did. Consider this a customer review and vlog. You hear that, IHE? There ain't enough room for two cynical LEGO lovers on this platform, and this Yankee is going to tell you Brits how it's really done.
So this is what I've been working on for the past 2 years or so. It's pretty large. There's some other bends. There's the Millennium Falcon. There's a few others. I'm gonna be taking pieces from these bends and putting them onto the mock. I have them numbered, and, there's a few more, and there's my dog, Balto. Say hi, Balto. Yeah.
Since I didn't want to spend $1,000 on a LEGO set that isn't even official, I decided to gather as many pieces from my collection as possible. Over the past 2 years, I've been organizing my enormous conglomeration of pieces, on and off, in a complicated system based on color, type, and how common they are, which will track how many pieces I have in the form of a percentage, and give me a price for all the rest I need. Now, 50 buckaroos may seem expensive just for instructions and a parts list, and I can't really tell you if it's worth it or not. I don't have many points of reference, but I can say I have a good chunk of the model in my collection already. That's one of the reasons I chose this model, because when I looked at it, it seemed like it contained a lot of pieces I already owned, and as of recording this, I'm already at 32% of what I need. Okay, boyos, so this is what we're gonna be attempting to build, the UCS Resurgent Class Star Destroyer. It's 7,855 pieces, which is a couple hundred more than the Millennium Falcon, the largest LEGO set ever created, commercially available. The Brick Vault website, the process for getting this thing, the instructions and the parts list, is relatively simple. I downloaded a zip file, I opened up a PDF and a parts list, I copied and pasted a bunch of text into a BrickLink parts list. They have a video that explains it all. There's a couple of ways you can do the instructions. I'm just gonna do the PDF because it's easier for me, and I can read them pretty well. So yeah, that's the plan. This is going to take a really long time. I need 281 of these 1x1 plates. I have to count that all out.
92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98,
The price here says about 1,000. That's for the entire thing. So far, I've gathered about 69% of what I need for the model. And that's not a meme. I didn't do that on purpose. It just came out that way. 69%. So that gives us about $600 off the price, slashes it off. I'll see if I can get a little lower. I'll scavenge for as many parts as I can. That'll probably bring down the price to about $500, which is a lot for a LEGO set, I will admit. Compared to the UCS Millennium Falcon, it's not too bad. So this is the actual thing from the movie. That's the model it's based off of. As you can see, there's a lot of multicolored pieces. The color is not applicable. So these are going to be on the inside of the model, the skeleton, if you will. And I have quite a bit of those, so that's gonna take up a lot of the pieces.
So I want to give you guys a sense of scale here. There's probably about 5,000 pieces in these bags, and each bag probably has about 500 pieces, give or take. They're ordered by color, obviously. This is about 70% of the mock. The multicolored pieces over there are the skeleton, and I'm going to collect as many pieces as I can to see how much more of the mock I can get, and I'll check in and see how much I got.
I am now at 73%. I've ordered a few pieces as an experiment, and now it is time to prepare and wait.